No way. Wow. Oh, hey friends. Welcome to Christ Kids TV. Let me ask you guys a question. Do you all like to watch shows? I do. I like to get my popcorn, get some snack, watch something on my tablet. Well, today on Christ Kids TV, we have a special show for you. Our very own high school students created this entire show, and they're going to perform it for you today. You get a chance to see they play the instruments and sing and do all kinds of cool stuff. So I want you guys to settle in, get your snack, and enjoy the Xperience comeback tour.
The Xperience is
music, community,
opportunity,
family,
faith building,
exciting,
fun with friends,
learning new skills,
a time of community and fellowship,
jamming and playing music with friends,
my time away from the outside world.
For 2 years, we've been apart.
But now we're back.
This is our comeback tour. We are
the Xperience.
Every anxious thought that steals my breath, it's a heavy weight upon my chest. As I lie awake and wonder what the future will hold, help me to remember that you're in control. You're my courage when I worry in the dead of night. You're my strength, cause I'm not strong enough to win this fight. You are greater than the battle raging in my mind. I will trust you, Lord. I will fear no more. I will lift my eyes. I will lift my cares. Lay them in your hands. I'll leave them there. When the wind and waves are coming, you shelter me. Even though I'm in the storm is not in me. You're my courage when I worry in the dead of night. You're my strength, cause I'm not strong enough to win this fight. Darkness can overwhelm me, cause you've already
What's up, Lutheridge? My name's Owen.
And my name is Hannah.
And the band and crew that you see before you is The Xperience.
So behind me, we have Cole on the rhythm guitar. We have Peyton on acoustic. We have Thomas on the bass. We have Bill on the drums. And we have Gabe on lead electric. And we have Mark on the piano.
And then behind you guys, we have Alex on slides, Holly on lights, Dana on sound, Nate and Haley on cams, and Pastor Melody is here for our support.
For those of you all who are not familiar with The Xperience, we are a youth-led, adult-mentored group whose goal is to spread the word and tell the story.
Our show may look a little different than it has in the past. We used to be a choir of over 80 singers, but with what's been going on these past couple of years, we've had to make some changes. Now, before we get back into singing, we encourage you guys to stand up for these next few songs and clap along and sing with us. It'll make the worship experience more enjoyable for everyone.
The Xperience usually goes on tour every summer, but we haven't been able to for the past 2 years, which is why this one is so important to us. What do you say, Owen? Are you ready to get back to singing?
Yeah, I am, but there's a question I have to ask you first.
What's up?
Do you ever have those days where you wish you just weren't yourself?
Well, what do you mean?
I don't know. There's some days I wish I was a little bit more like Jesus, a little less like me. Come on.
Yeah, I have days I lose the fight. I try my best, but just don't get it right. Where I talk a talk that I don't walk and miss the moments right before my eyes. Somebody with a hurt that could have helped. Somebody with a hand that could have helped. When I just can't see past myself, Lord, help me be
a little more like mercy, a little more like grace, a little more like kindness, goodness, love, and faith. A little more like patience, a little more like peace, a little more like Jesus,
a little less like.
Yeah, there's no denying that I have changed. I've been saved from who I used to be. But even at my best, I must confess, I still need help to see the way you see. Somebody with a hurt that I could have helped. Somebody with a hand that I could have held. When I just can't see past myself, Lord, help me be a little more like mercy, a little more like grace, a little more like kindness, goodness, love, and faith. A little more like patience, a little more like peace, a little more like Jesus, a little less like me. Oh, to feed the beggar on the street, love to be our hands and feet, freely give what I receive, Lord, help me be. I want to put you first above all else, love my neighbor as myself, in the moments no one sees, Lord, help me be.
All together.
Everything I preach,
know y'all know this one. Come on, sing along with me.
Before I spoke a word, you were singing over me. You have been so, so good to me. Before I took a breath, you breathed your life in me. You have been so, so kind. Oh, the overwhelming, never-ending, reckless love of God. Oh, it chases me down, fights till I'm found. Please, the 99, I couldn't earn it, and I don't deserve it. Still, you give yourself away. Oh, the overwhelming, never-ending, reckless love of God, yeah, yeah.
Love it over here, love it.
When I was your foe, still your love fought. You have been so, so good to me. I felt no worth, you paid it all for me. You have been so, so kind to me. Oh, the deserve it, still you give yourself away. Though the overwhelming, never-ending, reckless love of God.
With me.
No shadow you won't light up, no mountain you won't climb up, coming after me. There's no wall you won't kick down, lie you won't tear down, coming after me. There's no shadow you won't light up, no mountain you won't climb up, coming after me. There's no wall
sing it, church.
There's no shadow you won't light up, mountain you won't climb up, coming after me. There's no wall you won't kick down, lie you won't tear down, coming after me. Whoa, the overwhelming, never-ending, reckless love of God. Whoa, yourself.
Some people want a real cool faith story, like you read about in books or watch in the Lifetime movies. They always come from these hard, messed up backgrounds, turn their lives around, and are not completely committed to God. My story is about as boring as it gets. I was raised in the church, this church to be more exact. I was baptized by my grandpa, and since then, now, I can't confirm this, but I might have only missed 3 Sundays in church. My parents are believers, they're still married, we live well, and no one has a gambling or a drug problem. Faith and the church have always been a part of my life, and I'm sure you have a similar story too. But let me ask you this. When did faith become real to you? When did you truly feel God's reckless love? When was church no longer something your family just did every Sunday, but something that became real and important to you, like it did for me? I remember going to camp the summer before 8th grade. I didn't really have huge expectations. My friends were going. It was kind of a requirement for confirmation. And it was summer, so I went. I remember this one hike in particular. It wasn't really that long in distance, but it sure was steep, going all the way up the mountain. And when we got to the top, we could see for miles in every direction. I guess we had a Bible lesson, and I suppose we had a prayer, but what I distinctly remember was the view. It was being surrounded by God's beauty and in all of creation that I knew this world was not an accident, and neither was I. I met God on a mountaintop where he surrounded me with his glory. Psalm 19 says, "The heavens declare the glory of God, the skies proclaim the work of his hands." On that mountaintop, that's what I saw. The heavens and the mountains, the skies and the clouds, all proclaiming God's glory through the works of his hands. But it was more than just being in awe of the beauty of creation. It made me realize how special I was in the sight of the Lord. If this same God who created the heavens and the earth, put the stars in their places, dug out the oceans and raised up the mountains, knows me my name and claimed me as his child, then I'm all in. The song we just sang captures the feeling I had up on that mountain of this God with the reckless love who pursues me, this reckless love which we sing about. There's no shadow you won't light up, mountain you won't climb up, coming after me. There's no wall you won't kick down, lie you won't tear down, coming after me. Those verses are so powerful that we sing them 3 times. 3 times we say that his love will do anything for us, but this isn't baseball. It isn't 3 strikes and you're out. He won't just light up 3 shadows, climb up 3 mountains, kick down 3 walls, or tear down 3 lies. He'll do those things over 3 million times if we need him to, as many times as he has to. One thing about myself is that I'm a competitive swimmer, and I'm committed to swim in college next year. It's something everyone who has met me knows, and it's a huge part of who I am and a huge part of my identity. This past March, I had my final swim meet of the season. It's the biggest one, the one where we're expected to perform our best at. It's a 4-day meet, so really, at some point, you're bound to get tired. And that is exactly what happened to me on Saturday night. I remember getting home from the pool after finals and just being so tired to the point I was in tears. This moment was a shadow for me, where I was so exhausted I just didn't think I would be able to swim the next day, which, of course, is the day my best event was on, the 100 backstroke. So in that moment, I remember just praying that I would have enough energy to get through the day. And the next night, the Sunday before my race, I was going through my typical pre-race routine. I do 2 arm circles forward, 2 arm circles backwards with both hands, and then 3 tuck jumps, and then I pray before each and every race. Then once I jumped in to swim the race, I finished, looked up at the scoreboard, and saw a new best time. A time that placed 2nd and got very close to my college's school record. The light he lit in that moment was giving me that energy that I needed for the race, getting the results I wanted, and also breaking a college record in another event. Now, I want you to think of something in your life. Maybe it's a shadow like mine, maybe a mountain or a wall or a lie. Something that God has helped you with. Something he has given you guidance for. And I want you to keep thinking about it. Just keep it in the back of your mind. We think that these things can separate us from God, but they never do. Romans 8:38-39 says, "For I am convinced that neither death nor life, neither angels nor demons, neither the present nor the future, nor any powers, neither height nor depth, nor anything else in all of creation will be able to separate us from the love of God that is in Jesus Christ our Lord." These 2 verses show how strong his love for us is, and they show us how much he will do for us. There's nothing that I could do, nothing you could do, nothing any of us could do that would ever separate us from his love. It is because of his reckless love that we are able to turn to him no matter our sins. We usually don't think of love as being reckless. We tend to associate recklessness with harshness. 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 4 says that love is patient and love is kind. The next few verses also describe love, but nowhere do we ever see described as reckless. Yet, that's what God's love for us is. It's truly and purely reckless. When talking about this song, Corey Asbury said, "When I use the phrase, the reckless love of God, I'm not saying that God himself is reckless. I am, however, saying the way he loves is in many regards quite so. His love bankrupts heaven for you. His love doesn't consider himself first. He doesn't wonder what he'll gain or lose by simply putting himself out there. He gives himself away on the off chance that one of us might look back at him and offer ourselves in return. God's love is so reckless that he made the ultimate sacrifice for the world, for you and me, by giving up his only son for our sins. Only reckless love can do that. I want you to think, if God made the sacrifice for everyone who had yet to walk the earth, then what will stop him from helping you through your own difficult times? Your life and your journey through this life was carefully created by his hands and guided by his vision for you. And he will stop at nothing to pull you into the light and towards the cross. In the everyday waters of baptism, his reckless love came to me. In a loving home with faithful parents, his reckless love came to me. On the ordinary mountaintop, his reckless love came to me. This reckless love that came to me is about as dangerous and as wild as it gets. For in this reckless love, I am found."
For this next song, you guys are welcome to stay seated. We would like to welcome Holly up to the stage with us.
Oh,
you look back. Don't you look back. Don't you look back. So the song Burn the Ships is about letting go of all of the distractions, burdens, obstacles, and anything that you need to give up to God. Tonight on your way in, Pastor Melody handed you a piece of paper and a pencil, and you all got together as your cabin groups and wrote down any burdens, distractions, or anything that is weighing on you that you need to give up to God. During this next song, we would like you to remember those burdens and just think about them as you listen to the lyrics of this next song. And at the end, Pastor Melody will come around, and if the camp counselors will just raise their hands, she will come to you all and pick up your piece of paper. Stand up. Tallest trees to the human life of you and me, from the desert sands to the place we stand. He's God of all, He's everything. Whoa.
In my life, you're the only one who makes the moon reflect the sun. Like starry night. That was His design. I'm giving my life to the only Son who was and is and yet to come. Let the praises ring. His design. I'm giving my life to the only Son who was and is and yet to come. Let the praises ring. He is everything.
The garage will sing.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I believe.
Collected all of your papers that expressed your thoughts and concerns that you need to give up to God. So pray with me. Holy Father, we come to you tonight with heavy hearts and weight on our shoulders that are too much for us to carry on our own. Lord, take these away from us. In Jesus' holy name, we pray. Amen. We are going to light these papers on fire and watch all of the worries and burdens disappear out of our hands.
Every day this never-ending pressure tries to take its claim over my heart. And I have tried to hold it all together, but time and time again I fall apart. But that's where I find my life was never mine at all. But you are the one inside, always in control.
So when it feels like all of this pain is never gonna end, I turn my knees by all of these things I don't understand, I don't understand. I'll let the weight of my fears fall like sand
out of my hands and into yours. Letting go of worries I can't measure, and holding on to truth that's healing me. Knowing I can trust you is a treasure. With eyes wide open now I finally see. It's here that I find my life was never mine at all. But you are the one inside, always in control. So when it feels like all of this pain is never gonna end, I'm to my knees by all of these things I don't understand, I don't understand. I will let the weight of my fears fall like sand out of my hands and into yours. Out of my hands, take this out of my hands, take this out of my hands, it's out of my hands.
There's nothing that you can't handle, God, you are strong enough, only you can take this out of my hands, out of my hands.
You're greater than all my sorrows, worthy of all my trust. Lord, that this is out of my hands, out of my hands.
So when it feels like all of this pain is never gonna end, but to my knees by all of these things I don't understand, I don't understand. I will let the weight of my fears fall like sand
out of my hands and into yours.
Out of my hands.
Take this out of my hands.
Take this out of my hands.
Take this out of my hands. It's out of my hands. Take this out of my hands. Take this out of my hands. Take this out of my hands. It's out of my hands.
Awesome. You guys are awesome. So at this point in the show, I'm going to give the band a bit of a break, and I welcome you guys to sit down. So a little bit about me. My name's Owen. Hey, guys. What's up? How's your night going? How's it going? Awesome. Awesome. So yeah, my name's Owen. I'm a rising senior. I've been going to Christ Lutheran Church in Charlotte, where we're from, for about 10 years now. I've been part of this great group, The Xperience, for 3 of those years. This is my first tour, and I've actually been a camper here for 9 years as well. It's so good to be back. So good to be back here at Lutheran. And for the past 3 years, I've been going to a school called Myers Park. And if you didn't know, Myers Park is actually the largest high school in North Carolina. 3,600 kids. It's a really big school. I like to describe it as being the epitome of being a small fish in a large pond. It is huge. It is overwhelming. But when you go to a big school like that, what you want to do is find ways to make your school experience smaller. Find your group, if you will, right? And a way that I was able to do that was my chorus class. I always loved chorus because it was a place for me to be with my friends who love to do the same thing that I love to do, which was sing. I love to sing. It's my passion. It fills me up, fills up my soul. But for the past few years at Myers Park, mostly due to COVID, there's actually been a decline in the chorus program at Myers Park. So much, in fact, that this past year we actually lost our chorus teacher. She was let go. And after I lost my teacher, the class just kind of felt different. Now, of course, the state had to give us a sub. And we still sang every day, but it's almost like we lost our passion for what we did. We lost our motivation to make beautiful music anymore. And that hurt me, because music is something that I love. Singing is something that I can't see myself not doing. And this class that had once been the highlight of my day slowly became something that I dreaded. And it came to a point where I had to sit my mom down and tell her, "Mom, I just can't do this anymore." She actually brought up an interesting solution, one that I thought was kind of a joke at first. But after a lot of thought, prayer, and consideration, I actually think it's the best thing for me. So, next August, for my senior year, I'll be switching schools. It sounds a bit crazy saying it out loud because it kind of is. But yeah, that's what's happening. Next August, I will be attending a much smaller art school with only about 600 kids, but only about 120 in our class. But I'm actually really excited for it. I think this is the path that God wants me to walk along. I'm excited for the new opportunities that lay ahead. I'm excited to meet new people. I'm honestly just excited to be in a new place. I feel like God is calling me in this direction, and everything about it is making me excited. But it's a big change, possibly the biggest change that I've had to make in my life so far. And I'd be lying to you if I told you that there wasn't this sneaking feeling in the back of my head that this could all be one big mistake. Now, I'm sure I speak for most of us when I say that there are some moments in our lives that we wished that we could just take back and redo. Words that were said with too much anger. Actions that deeply hurt someone that we care about. And moments that we could just overall erase. Everyone has them. It's a part of life. It's a part of being human. And this past year, I actually had one of those moments. And I deeply hurt some of my best friends. Now, I won't go into details on what happened because, honestly, the details don't really matter. The fact is, I made a careless, reckless mistake. And my friends were hurt by it. Now, I didn't mean to hurt them. In fact, I thought I was doing the right thing. But a lapse of judgment led to the severing in a relationship. And I couldn't take it back. I still can't. And I tried to say sorry. I tried to say sorry so many times. Because in my youthful brain, saying sorry always makes everything better, doesn't it? Well, no, it doesn't. And that was a hard lesson to learn. And no matter how many times I said I was sorry, no matter how much I told them I meant it, they would just give me the same answer. I mean, they would say, "Owen, it's too much. It's too much. I mean, how could someone forgive something like that?" And those words stuck with me. How could someone forgive something like that? And slowly, these voices began circulating in my mind with lies, saying stuff that I'm sure a few of you are familiar with. Things like, "You're no good. You're a screw-up. And that's all you'll ever be. I mean, you had some amazing friends, and you messed it all up." I mean, how does someone manage to do something like that? and it wasn't long before I began to believe them. Because that's the thing about me, guys, is I got a good memory, and I don't let myself forget. And there began this time in my life where for months, this mistake would be the first thing that I thought about in the morning, the last thing that I would think about before I went to bed. I mean, I thought about it in the shower, in the car, during math class, even during church. I mean, this mistake was just eating me alive. And I was broken. I couldn't escape it. I couldn't let it go. Or is it that I wouldn't let it go? You see, I don't know if my friends will ever forgive me for what happened. But I know one thing for sure. And that's that God forgave me. He forgave me before I even made the mistake. He knew I was going to make my mistake. And he still forgave me. I've known that God forgives me from the earliest moments of going to my church. I've been blessed to grow up in such an amazingly faithful household, to have this group in the Xperiance, and not to mention this place at Lutheridge where I can come year after year. And grasping on to God's forgiveness, and with the help of some very important people in my life, I realized something. I realized that I had to forgive myself. Not because I deserved it in any way, but because I was born broken. I was born fallen. There's nothing that I can do, there's nothing that any of us can do that can change that. But God loved us so much. I mean, he loved us so much that he sent his only son, Jesus, to die. Not to clear his conscience, but to clear yours and to clear mine, so that no amount of sin, guilt, or shame could ever separate us from him again. I mean, isn't that amazing love? So the next time you feel too broken, too alone, or too hopeless to be used by God, I want you to turn to his word. And there, you'll see that Jacob was a liar. Moses was a murderer. Rahab was a prostitute. Thomas doubted. David had an affair. And Peter denied Jesus. And every single one of these guilty, sinful people were used to build up his kingdom. And I believe that God is using me here and now to declare that we don't have to live in our sin and shame anymore, because he has taken the weight of our fear and brokenness out of our hands. You're not too broken to be used by God. I mean, that's one of Satan's biggest lies. No one, and I mean no one, can condemn me. For even when that whisper nags me in the middle of the night, filling me with guilt and regret, saying things like, "Don't you remember what you did?" I'll tell that voice, "No. No, I don't. In fact, I distinctly remember forgetting it. Because if this God is for me, and he is, then nothing and no one could ever come against me. Not even with this good memory of mine." Pray with me. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for new beginnings. We thank you for new opportunities. But most of all, we thank you for your son, Jesus, who on that day died for our sins so that we could live with you in eternity forever. In your name we pray. Amen. Come on. Down.
He's roaring with power and fighting our battles, and every knee will bow before Him. Our God is the Lamb that was slain for the sins of the world. His blood breaks the chains, and every knee will bow before the Lion and the Lamb. Every knee will bow before Him. So open up the gates, make way before the King of Kings. The God who comes to save is here to set the captives free. For who can stop the Lord Almighty? Our God is the Lion of Judah. He's roaring with power and fighting our battles, and every knee will bow before Him. Our God is the Lamb that was slain for the sins of the world. His blood breaks the chains, and every knee will bow before the Lion and the Lamb. Every knee will bow before Him.
If the Lord's been good to you all this week, raise your hands in the air.
Who can stop the Lord Almighty? Who can stop the Lord Almighty? Who can stop the Lord Almighty? Roaring with power and fighting our battles, and every knee will bow before Him. Our God is the Lamb that was slain for the sins of the world. His blood breaks the chains, and every knee will bow before the Lion and the Lamb. Every knee will bow before Him.
Every knee will bow, tongue confess. So the Xperience has been a high school music group of Christ Lutheran Church for about 24 years now, and the last two songs that we are getting ready to sing, we have sung like pretty much the entire time, and we would not be the Xperience without them. Now's the time when we normally would call up alumni to come sing them with us. And I see you.
Give me a hand, give me a hand.
What's your name?
I'm Ashton.
Ashton!
None of you know me, but I'm a...
of men, and We can hear the Great Commission calling to the church again. We gotta bring in the lost, gotta send out the found, so they can bring in the lost, and we can send out the found. Somebody tell somebody what his love is all about. We gotta bring in the lost and send out the found. We are called to tell the story, lead the lost to the Lord. There's a world in need of healing right outside these doors. When we reach out to our brothers with the answers that they need, God is building up his kingdom and he's calling you and me. We gotta bring in the lost, gotta send out the found, so they can bring in the lost and we can send out the found. Somebody tell somebody what his love is all about. We gotta bring in the lost and send out the found. Gotta send out the found so they can bring in the lost and we can send out the found. Somebody tell somebody what his love is all about. Somebody tell somebody what his love is all about. Somebody tell somebody what his love is all about. We gotta bring in the lost and send out the found. And send out the found. And send out the found.
Oh yeah, forgot this one.
Lord, I wanna feel your heart and see the world through your eyes. I wanna be your hands and feet. I wanna live a life that leads. Ready yourselves, ready yourselves.
Let us shine the light of Jesus in the darkest night.
Ready yourselves, ready yourselves.
In the paths of darkness tremble as our praise is high.
Until the whole world hears, Lord, we are calling out. Lifting up your name. For us to hear the sound, like voices in the wilderness, we're crying out. As the day draws near, sing until the whole world hears. Your name for all to hear the sound.
calling out, lifting up your name for all to hear the sound, like voices in the wilderness we're crying out, as the day draws near, sing till the whole world hears, whoa, whoa. Whoa, whoa, sing it till the whole world hears. Whoa, whoa, sing it till the whole world hears. Whoa.
Thank you so much, Luther Ridge. You guys are awesome.
Go out and tell the stories. We'll see you next time.
Thanks for joining us this week on Christ Kids TV.